Jesus said unto her, Didn't I tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? John chapter 11, verse 40.
Our heart is hard.
And our
ear too is hard.
Women
are softer when it comes to the things of God.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As for men, when God moves us, we don't move. We are standing there, like a water. The rock of ages. We don't move. May the Lord soften your husband for you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Faith is not equal to a shaking. Faith is not equal to a falling down. Faith is not equal to a scream. Faith is a substance.
God bless you for availing yourself for the things of God. To sing to His glory. To play instrument to His glory. To take photographs to His glory. To operate equipment to His glory. To come to His presence to receive His word. The Lord bless you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, Holy Ghost. When Jesus was living, He gave you to us. And He gave us to you. Say, Holy Ghost. You are all I have. I am here. Because I love you. I am here. Because I love Jesus. I am here. Because I love the Father. Holy Ghost. Let my coming here not be wasted. Let it not be wasted. Say, Holy Ghost, touch my life. Change my life. Do something new in my life. Say, Holy Ghost, I want to encounter you. I want to know you. I want to experience you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If I want to know where you stand, I just have to hear something that you say about God or the things of God. Then I know whether you are for God or you are not. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20.
It
says that we are ambassadors of the Lord Jesus Christ. We are Christ's ambassadors. And God is making His appeal through us. We speak for
Christ.
Telling people to come back to God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Some people make adverts for football. They promote football. That's why they can go and stand on, they can go and sit on television every Monday. They promote football. Every morning, broadcasting stations, radio, they give 30 minutes, solid 30 minutes minimum to football. They promote football. They are ambassadors of soccer. Something that is just
ethnic.
They value it. They promote it. They defend it. Something that is just earthly entertainment. They defend Arsenal and they defend Barca. They make argument for Barcelona. They make argument for Chelsea. They make argument for Kotoko. Something that is just ethnic. To entertain the flesh. We are people of God. When was the last time you made some argument for God? When was the last time you defended God? Are you the one that accuses God and the things of God, or you defend God? If we cannot defend God, then what is our use? We have to speak for God when others are speaking for soccer and football. Then we have become useful to God. Am I communicating to someone
here?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Say, Holy Ghost, anoint me. Empower
me
to speak for you. Say, Holy Ghost, give me the wisdom. Give me the insight to speak and promote your kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ. People know how to creatively promote their political parties. But they don't know how to promote their God. We are failing. We have misplaced our priorities. We must elevate eternal things. We must elevate things that are beyond the earth. So whilst you are promoting the things of the earth, whilst you are promoting soccer, whilst you are promoting your party, promote God above those things. As long as we are on earth, we will be dealing with some of these physical things. But God must have his first place. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So if you cannot speak for God, then are you for him or you are against him?
It is all to mean that some men are
Am I communicating to somebody here? At all? How do you feel when they talk against your soccer team? How do you feel when you hear that somebody is speaking against your political party? How do you feel? How do you feel when you hear that somebody is talking against your presidential candidate? How do you feel? You are not happy. You want to talk back at the person. You want to silence the person. What about the Almighty? The one who gave you life.
Your mouth.
The one who gave you strength.
Your mouth.
The one who gave you your expertise.
Your mouth.
What about him?
Now, no.
Are you able? How do you feel when people talk against you? Do you feel the pain or you don't care? If you don't care, it means there's a problem with your Christianity. It means you are not for God. It means that you have just come to mix up with the number. You need a soul tie with your God. You need a soul tie with your God. You need a soul tie with God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 So the Christianity we are talking about, it must be a serious Christianity, not a joke. When they speak against God, you must feel it. It means you truly belong to God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Many of us, when we were growing up, our fathers were drunkards. Who is a witness here? When we were growing up, our fathers were drunkards. At times, our fathers would even drink and then they would lie down. But even though your father is a drunkard, even though he's a smoker, when somebody insults your father, you will feel it. You will never be happy with him. The one who insults your father. Your father might have maltreated you, your mother might have maltreated you.
See, if you now, Papa, why you're Basaba, say, if now, Mamma, so why you're Basaba.
You don't allow anybody to insult you.
And so, Ma will be out from
you. Don't allow anybody to talk rough about you. Your parents. How will you sit down when people insult your God?
Send a who so be here with Yankopon.
And they insult the things that stand for your God.
No more, yeah, near my age now, Ma with Yankopon.
You don't care.
And foul.
It means there's no link between you and God.
Wait, just a wouldn't you rather than tell us, and Yankopon,
it means you don't love your God. And when you don't love your God, when you need him, he will also give you God. If we are following God, let's love him. Let's follow him. We have been called to promote God. We have been called to promote God. Others promote other things. We promote something different. We have been called to promote God. We have an eternal destination. That is what we stand for. And that is what we speak for. Does God know you? Does he know you? You must place God at the place that he deserves in our lives.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, don't forsake the assembling of yourselves together. Don't. Hebrews 10:25. That is the word of God. That is the word of God. Don't allow any philosopher, whatever any philosopher is saying, anywhere to confuse you. The word of God says, don't forsake the gathering of ourselves together. Don't forsake it. Don't stop it.
I say, Ma, we are waiting for tribute and now. Trust me, say, Ma,
we gather because it is a command from God.
Yes, your son said, your child is very thing.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So I've always said, if we cannot gather plenty like this, we can gather two or three in Mr. Boko's house. Two or three.
We can go to
Mr. Boko's house and gather there. If we cannot gather plenty like this,
we
can go to Auntie Millicent's house and gather two, three there with the word of God. If
you
cannot gather plenty like this, four or five of us can go to Mr. Crunchy's house and gather there with the word of God.
He said,
don't stop gathering. Facebook cannot replace this one. Television cannot replace this one. This is the command of God.
Don't
stop gathering. When you are far away, and you cannot go for the meeting or the gathering, Facebook becomes a temporal, or television becomes a substitute, a temporal substitute.
Facebook and other kasamfonye
not the main thing. The main thing is this. The main thing is that you don't forsake the assembly. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In Matthew chapter 8, verse 15. Matthew chapter 8, verse 5. And when Jesus entered into Capernaum, there came to him a centurion beseeching him, saying, Lord, my servant is at home sick, grievously paralyzed and tormented.
Jesus said,
I will come and I will heal him. Then the army commander said, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof. Especially if you want to look at verse
7.
Jesus said, I will come and heal him. So healing is the will of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, I will come and heal him. So it is the will of Jesus, it's the will of God to heal people. If people want healing, they must get connected to Jesus Christ. Being healed by God is not maybe if and not. He said, I will come. It is my will. I will come. Not I may come. I will. I will. Not I may. I will come. So it is his will to heal you. Say Jesus. It is your will to heal me. Heal me now. Heal me now. In the name of Jesus Christ. There are some sicknesses that are hiding. They may not manifest. It has to heal you before it will even try to manifest. There are some people who have corona, but it has not manifest, but they have it. And they are sharing it to people. So if one of such people happen to enter the church, it has not manifested yet. But when it comes, Jesus will heal him. So it will never be able to manifest. Say in the name of Jesus. Any sickness trying to hide in my body, whether malaria, whether affliction, wherever it is hiding in my body, Jesus Christ, you let me now. Jesus Christ is healing me now. In the name of Jesus
Christ.
Verse 8. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof. But speak the word only. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That's the level you have to get to. Where the word of God is enough.
He
says, speak the word only. Don't lay hands on me. Just speak the word. Don't push my head. Don't push me down. Just the word. When I hear the word, I receive my answer. Am I communicating at all? Just speak the word only. The word of God is enough. It's enough. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Until you get to the level where you respect the word of God, you will not last in Christianity. Until you come to the level where you respect the word of God, you will not last in Christianity. If you don't uphold the word of God, if you don't regard the word of God, and you want something above the word of God, your Christianity will be temporary. The enemy can uproot you from the Christianity. It is the word of God that empowers you. It is the word of God that establishes you. It is the word of God that causes you to last in your walk with God.
So
anybody going to church and is going to church not because of the word of God, and it's going to church because of something else, mark it on the wall, the person will stop church one day. Will stop church one day.
He
can grow to become a reverend in the church.
He
can grow to become a bishop in the church. If it is not because of the word of God, he's in the church. And it's because of something else, mark it on the wall. He will leave the church one day. It can take him 30 years, he will still leave. Because the word that will plant him is not there. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I was talking to you about when Bishop started in Tamale, a certain man came to the church and the person was healed, miraculous. And the person stopped coming to church. Then he made the person say, "Oh God, why are you not coming to church?"
Now you be saying, "Son, I didn't think I was mad, sorry."
He said, "Ah, have you heard some before that somebody went to hospital and he was healed in the hospital and he's still at the hospital?"
I said, "Now what did that so be a fire yarisabia? No one yarisa no gusu alcohol no one."
The person, once he's healed, he leave the hospital.
I said, "No one yarisa pe na kese we feel."
That means that the motivation of the person for coming to church is not God and it's not the word of God.
What that say be a Kenya nipa no more ba sorry no na nyanya me na nyanya nyanya me.
So once he got the thing, he will not last in church.
If you do obenya adie no sisi no enya di obetcha wasafu no.
You may be looking for something that. That's why you come to God. But when you come, we will fix your mind on the word. We will fix your mind on the word. That is what will make you to last. So that after you have gotten the thing, you will still remain connected to God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Am I communicating at all? I have met a lot of people in church. I've booked deliverance for them.
What's why? Yeah, or dear, I'm a woman. Yeah, what's the two Adam and who, Mama?
Fight a lot of spiritual battles.
Yeah, what who,
spend a lot of time on them.
Yeah, no, why send me the prayer?
Remove obstacles and hindrances on their way.
Yeah, why you are coinciding? Yeah, but since you are
they get miracles and they get the answers.
Oh, when you are sent training, I know you know more here now.
After that, they leave church.
I said, no, it's no more fear.
Because we didn't succeed in fixing their mind on the word. Your mind is only on what they were looking for.
No, imagine you next year.
If you want to last in God, start focusing on the word of God. Your title and position cannot keep you in the house.
It is the word of God
that will keep you in the house of God. When the word of God begins to influence you, the decisions of your life will be according to the will of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Am I communicating at all? Am I talking to somebody at all? There are times you can get so much angry you want to do something. If you are somebody that the word of God influences you, because of the word, you don't do what you want to do. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The word. Speak the word only. Speak the word only. Speak the word only. Say, Holy Ghost, as I am receiving the word, fall upon me. Say, Holy Ghost, as I am receiving the word, fall upon me. Say, Holy Ghost, as I am hearing the word, fall upon me. Let your nature, let your presence, let your power, let your glory, let your revival, let your wisdom fall upon me right now. Holy Ghost, fall upon me as I am hearing the word. In the name of Jesus, say, Holy Ghost, change my life as I am hearing the word. Say, Holy Ghost, revive me as I am hearing the word. In the name of Jesus, say, I want to last. Say, I want to last. Say, I want to last. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Many people have kerosene revival. They don't. Their revival is kerosene revival. Please go back to Acts 10:44. We'll come back to the book of Matthew. Many people's revival is kerosene revival. Kerosene revival is the revival where you are committed for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. Then after that, Otilo.
A secret thing or show bono, and you'll be at all who are who farmer, best after back, Fibian, Fibian, not fair, no, I don't know why you are.
We don't see you again.
Yeah, who be
because your miracle that you were looking for, you didn't get it.
It's unsay, and Saint Janina now is the Noenia.
Well, when God is looking for you, he will not find you anywhere.
But well,
you are not interested in God. You are not interested in God. You are not interested in his word. You are not interested in your salvation. You are just interested in some earthly miracle. That is all you are
interested in.
So, your revival, good, crazy, good, bobo revival. You know bobo.
And if you want to come again,
1 year, 2 years, 3 years, we don't see you. 1 year, 5 years, God is looking for you.
Say,
Holy Ghost, I don't want Christian revival. I want gas revival. I want petrol revival. And I want bushfire revival. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Talking about revival where you are consistent. Am I communicating at all? You don't get to the level where they say they are ni, they are jama, small boys, no more ye.
So we don't pen so be able to catch the ni, the jama and falano.
But some will chow if you. But some will chow if you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
One day they ask somebody that. You are close to pastor. Why is that when pastor is praying with people in the church, you are not there? So,
synchrophobia will be so who been so for pa. I didn't think that so for our own synchrophobia bumper. Yeah, would you want come?
Oh, he said, oh, you are boy. See, it's a small boy. So, I'm on the drum. So, I'm going to go. Then the person has the person that hey, but the. Bishop Pastor David himself is there praying the people. He has not arrived. And you that you are following him now, you have arrived. You will not pray with the people.
Then any panel beside panel on any castle. Hey, now so for David on more and I will do an.
It means that person has been cut off from the anointing on the man of he has been cut off. So he has lost desire for spiritual things. When you lose your stirring to pray, you are finished. When you lose your stirring to pray,
prayer
is fire generator. The more you are praying, Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And when your prayer comes down,
now some people
you are finished.
Why
you
pray?
I've worked with Bishop for years.
So I know some people are not in fear, baby.
Recently, he started organizing some prayer with church members on Monday mornings.
But in Asante, be our church, any as a woman who help on pay, you are done up
there. When some of the church members come Monday mornings, when I go there, Bishop himself is there. Because nobody is more powerful than his prayer. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I am a product of a Ginasari. That is why I pray.
God,
he is a man of prayer. If
you
are connected to me,
and
you don't love prayer, one day you leave the church. If you are connected to me,
so
and you don't like prayer,
some
because prayer is the thing. Prayer plus the word. Plus holiness, plus righteousness. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He said, while Peter was speaking the words of God, Holy Ghost fell on them. When they were hearing the word. So when you are hearing the word, you are not joking. It's a serious matter. Say, Holy Ghost, fall on me. So anytime you are coming to church, tell the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, as I'm hearing your word, fall on me. With your power. Fall on me. With your fire. Fall on me. With your revival. Fall on me. With your wisdom. Fall on me. With your creativity. As you are hearing the word, things are happening. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And it is more dangerous and powerful when the one speaking the word is also a man of prayer who has spent time in secret with God. It becomes more dangerous.
Jonathan. So I was saying Rabompaye as you are some naive.
The days in which we live.
Since I'm a woman.
We need people who are really for God.
Who are
ready to pay some price for God.
Yeah, oh my credit or some baby be amerade.
Not people who will just be cut off by the least temptation and trial.
And young crofa be being sovereign and not so how could be a baby or my free honor.
We need some fire.
Praise the
Lord.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Am I communicating at all? We promote God. We talk about God. We promote the kingdom of God. We promote fidelity. Others can promote other things. We know why God has called us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you being blessed by the message? Right, you come to church, then I increase your desire for something else, not your desire for God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must become fire brand for God. As an old lady, as an old man, as a young lady, as a young man, you must be fire brand for the Lord. The Holy Ghost must fall upon your life. 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 You must be full of the Holy Ghost. You must be charged with the Holy Ghost. Don't be a nominal Christian. Motro mojo. No. Be for God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Stand for God. Speak for God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you don't have his fire, you are a pitiful person. Your love for him will die. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So in the book of Matthew, chapter 8, when you go to verse
13,
Jesus said unto the centurion, go as you have believed, so be it done unto you. And the servant was healed in the self same hour. The servant was healed in the self same hour. As you have believed, let it be done unto you. As you have believed, let it be done unto you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I don't want to be a Christian that is just mixed with a number that they can just overlook me. That's not the kind of Christian I want.
No.
I want to be a Christian who is a pillar for God.
So
person
or you be a Christian, ojina home dum
for God. But when God is looking for people who are pillars for him, your name shall be among them.
Say,
I receive that baptism of the Holy Ghost. Say, I receive that baptism of the Holy Ghost. Say, I receive that baptism of the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. A praying pastor will produce a praying church. If you find yourself in a prayerless church, you are not safe.
So sorry, be more mumpire, dear, and you will bamboo.
If you find yourself in a prayerless church, you are not safe.
So sorry, be a young mumpire, you will be bamboo.
Demons can do with you whatever they want.
At that money, who will bet me, your dear,
but when you are in a prayerful church,
now, sorry, I am mumpire,
it is dangerous to touch members of the church. You need to be extra brave as a demon to touch the members of the church. Because there is protection on them. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So no matter how weak I am, I don't joke with my prayer.
So I'm fun and pipe.
I'm telling the people who pray with me. I have been telling them that if I don't call you, that let's go and pray. Don't sit down and be sleeping because me, I'm praying somewhere. The only reason why I call you that let's go and pray is that I want to help you to also grow in prayer. It doesn't mean that you are not. I'm praying somewhere, hours. I'm doing something somewhere.
But
the only time when I call you that let's go and pray is that I want you to also get some of the fire. So when I come, by the grace of God, I carry the fire.
And unto so by and I'm a radiado so kit a jano.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Say Holy Ghost. I need you. Say Holy Ghost. I need you. If I live here without your touch,
yeah,
upon my life,
my bravo swa.
I am wasted. Say, Holy Ghost, I have come tonight. I need you. I need you. Say, so Holy Ghost, let your signature come upon my life tonight. Say, so Holy Ghost, let your signature come upon my life tonight. In the name of Jesus. Say, so Holy Ghost, I need your handwriting. Say,
so
Holy Ghost, I need your handwriting upon my life. In the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and pray. When you are talking to somebody, you are fellowshipping with the person.
So when you obey Kasana, that's a will you find in Yangofa.
Say Holy Ghost. As I pray in the Holy Ghost. Say Holy Ghost. As I pray in the Holy Ghost. Share your wisdom. In my life. Say Holy Ghost. As I pray in the Holy Ghost. Share your direction. In my life. Show me what to do. Say Holy Ghost. As I pray in tongues. Change my level. Take me to a higher level. Show me what to do. In the name of Jesus. When Jesus was there, God moved Joseph of Arimathea to come and give and offer his grave for Jesus to be buried in. God moved him. The Holy Ghost moved him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God must move somebody for you. God must move somebody for you. God must move your boss for you. God must move some helpers for you. God must move some human beings into your life to do something for you. The Holy Ghost. As I pray in the Holy Ghost. Move somebody for me. Spare somebody for me. Say Holy Ghost. As I pray in the Holy Ghost. As I'm fellowshipping with you. Move somebody for me. Spare somebody for me. Move somebody for me. To do something. Powerful. Great. In my life. For me now. Lift your voice and pray. It's moving some customers. It's moving some clients. In the name of Jesus. Lift your hands to him. Holy Ghost. I pray for your people. Holy Ghost. You are the best thing they can ever have. You are the best thing. Not the good thing. The best thing. That they can ever have. Holy Ghost. They are here because of you. Come upon them. Come upon them. Their lives must change. Come upon them. Let them be full of your power. Let them be full of your fire. Let them be full of your wisdom. Holy Ghost, come upon your people. Holy Ghost, come upon your people. Holy Ghost, come upon your people. In the name of Jesus, that they will know what to do. Holy Ghost, come upon them. That their life will not be ordinary. That their life will not be ordinary. Holy Ghost, come upon them. You came upon Mary Magdalene. You came upon the apostles. Come upon them. You came upon Stephen. You came upon Philip. Come upon your people. Tabernacle upon them. Tabernacle upon them. Overshadow them. Overshadow them. Tabernacle upon them. Overshadow them. Overshadow them. Make your people of power. Make them people of power. Make them people of revival. In the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost. As you have come upon them. Let them be unique. Let them be unique. Let them be special. In the name of Jesus. Extraordinary. 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 In everything they are doing. In everything that concerns them. Everywhere they go. Everything they touch. Every move they make. Extraordinary. 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 Every one of them. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.